Welcome back to the channel. I am so grateful that you are here, and today I am updating my 30 weeks of pregnancies. If you're new to the update, each week I'm talking about my physical, emotional, spiritual of my pregnancies and give you some tips. Let's start with the physical. So this week I weighed 123 pounds, so that nearly 56 kilograms. I have 10 more weeks to go. Baby is as big as a cantaloupe. This week I'm feeling a bit restless, probably because I have a very busy schedule this week. Every single day there's always activity going on. I have to go out, seeing new people, talking to doctor, OB, and do research and do a lot of work at the evening when Kiki goes to sleep. And also this week Kiki start having diaper rash, first time ever in her life. It creates such a discomfort for both of us. Basically she's in pain and I'm losing sleep. So this week I start giving her no more soya milk instead of using organic. I'm mixing it with other unsweetened organic milk. And that is the different things that I have done. So I've got to start eliminating the option to figure out which one exactly it caused. Overnight sleeping, when she wake up, her rash get better and then it getting worse later in the day. So it could be the humidity. Let's see, I will update you next week about that. For baby movement, I can really, really feel the kicking, either the moving, either it's the elbow, knee, hand, leg, all the movement. I feel it's more and more every day. And baby heartbeat is 146. Also, my bum start showing a bit of stretch mark, although I'm not quite sure if this is an old one or the new one. Speaking of which, let's take a look at my belly at week 30. Here is the belly at week 30. It's quite big, it's getting bigger. And here is the cantaloupe that inside me. Baby is big as the cantaloupe. Imagine carrying this every single day for 3 months. Probably getting heavier because it's riper. Moving on to emotional. This week, emotionally, I've done so little to prepare for my natural birth this week. Partly because I'm just so busy doing a lot of things during the day, and then evening, I got a new project. I'm just so excited with new idea of doing a parody pregnancies, and I've been watching so many of them on YouTube, so fun. Also, I haven't done any cooking for a while since mom was around, and she a great helping hand. But now she's away, and she's gonna be away for a long time. Probably she's gonna come back 3 days after, 3 days before my due day. So I got to go back in cooking and cleaning. Although I have to say, not cooking actually releases a lot of stress in my day. I mean, I know some of you might find the opposite, that cooking actually releases your stress, but I rather enjoy eating. You know? So I only have 10 weeks left, which means baby going to come anytime very soon. And also emotionally, after I seen the OB doctor this week, I came out with a bitter taste on my mouth when she told me that she won't allow me to do vaginal birth. And I have to do a C-section again according to her schedule as 40 weeks. I'm like, what? Why? I've been practicing it. I've been doing like hypnobirthing things. I've been doing like yoga, a lot of exercise. But you know, she's still like, no, you got to do C-section again. So at first I got very frustrated, but then I calmed myself down and really determined to have a natural vaginal birth at home. So if any of you have any experience about this, please do let me know, as I am desperate to find help and more information in the area where I'm living at the moment about VBAC and having a home birth. Okay, moving to spiritual. Although it's been a busy week, I had made more time to spend on myself. Although I haven't done much of self-care priority, but I feel connection and liberate my mind a lot, especially after the old B had told me striking news I wasn't happy with. We haven't decided a name for the baby yet because we are so focusing on our RV motorhome and shopping at the moment. So maybe I'm going to start the conversation and discuss with my husband about this, since he is in London at the moment and I'm in Florida. But he's gonna come by the end of the month, so maybe I'm gonna talk to him by the end of the month. Depends, let's see, I'll keep you updated. Now, let's moving on to tips for all of our pregnant mama this week. I know it's hard to get comfortable during the third trimester of pregnancies, and you have buckets, your baby kicking your ribs, and you give anything for this nice sleep, right? I'm going to share the best tip for handling many discomfort of late pregnancies and staying comfortable in the third trimester. First one is the egg around your proud belly. What you can do is you can give your baby and your lungs some room by keeping your back straight, slightly arches instead of slumping forward when you're sitting. That's actually helped a lot. It also helps with when you in labor as well, because when you sit straight up all the time, you stand up all the time, the baby will position itself for the head to go downward in order for it to come down. Or you can use a foam roller or tennis ball to relax all the thigh muscle around your shoulder or your back. Also, wearing a good comfortable flat shoe will help as well. I know high heel is very very attractive and if you look marvelous, but while you're pregnant, comfortable is the most important thing, right? Second, try massage and warm water therapy. You can let warm water running down your back in the shower. That feels great to me every day when I'm doing that. Or you can try taking a warm bath at night and getting your partner to rub you down. Tip number three is you can use a pillow for support. Sleep with a small travel pillow instead of those big bulky pregnancy pillows, because they give you a little boost where you need it, and you can save money on buying those pregnancy pillows which you won't use again after you're pregnant, right? And you can roll over easily as well. With me, I don't normally sleep with pillow, so now, because the bum is getting so big now, I start sleeping on my left side and just put one of my legs on the pillow. That gives me so much comfort. Or you can invest it in a really comfortable memory foam pillow, which you can use again after your pregnancy. And it's heavily you can use after pregnancy rather than those, you know, advertising pregnancy pillows. Number four, you can set yourself up for good sleep by, for example, if you can get comfortable in bed, try different spot, the couch or recliner, maybe your ticket to a good night's sleep. Why don't you try it out? And lastly, keep room temperature cool to a suitable degree at night for you. I know that some of us, our body temperature start changing because we got another human being inside us, so some of us probably feel either hotter or some of it feel colder, depend on how your body type is and where you live. So check out the temperatures and make sure it's the right for you over the night so you can have a good sleep as well. Tip number 5, exercise to soothe pregnancy ache and pain. In my last pregnancy, I do a lot of swimming, and swimming takes the weight off your body because the water will support your belly and all your joints, but not too cold and comfy as well. This pregnancy, I am actually doing a lot of yoga, so yoga every day. It's work wonder, seriously. You got to start doing it. Yoga is wonderful. It's nice, it's gentle. You not only your body relax, but also your mind relax. And that will lead to your baby relaxing as well. So that means at 30 weeks, I would love to hear from you. How are you doing? Has your pregnancy has been treating you? And are you planning natural birth? If you have any tips or any information about VBA, please put it in the comment below and let me know so I can educate myself better on this and start planning for my at-home birth. And thank you very much for watching. If you like the video, give me a thumb up. Also, don't forget to click on the subscribe button, ding, and the bell so you can see my next updating video. Thank you and goodbye!